How you doing, everybody? Randy Richard in the shop. And today we're going to do a modification on a 2007 Toyota Tundra steering rack so it will fit into a Toyota Tacoma. Most of the time this is done for racing, heavy-duty off-roading, rock crawling, any kind of four-wheeling like that for your Toyota Tacoma. The original Toyota Tacoma steering racks are junk, and you could end up going through 10 of those things easily. So this is a great modification if you want some really powerful steering ability for your Toyota Tacoma. So please watch the previous video on my son's truck. It gives you a greater overview of the truck and all the equipment and modifications and the stuff he's done to the thing. And for off-roading, for heavy-duty off-roading, rock crawling, camping even, and quasi-racing type of thing. It's quite the vehicle. It's really nice. And please watch the video on that. And if you want some really powerful steering, this is a great mod to have powerful steering ability, especially for rock crawlers and you know, any other high demand steering. The Toyota Tacoma steering rack is a very wimpy rack. It's really not very powerful. So when you start to put on bigger tires and start to demand a lot from the steering, it will break. It has a lot of pressed sheet metal type mounting on it, and they're very weak. So this mod is getting to be, I should say, popular amongst enthusiasts of rock crawling and racing. It's already been being done in racing and things like that. So let's just jump right in and start disassembly. This is a 2007 Toyota Tundra steering rack. I'm going to disassemble it. There's oil in it, so we're going to have a little bit of a mess, and I suggest wear gloves. Right here, this is a locking part to the pinion that is in here that drives valving for the hydraulics part of the rack. This is the rack right here. You can see here this rack gear. There's a pinion gear that engages in that. Remove this. And on the far end here, there's a snap ring and like a nut that needs to come out. We're going to take this out so we can put it in the lathe. This was really tight, so I was able to get this loose, made a little block up that fits right in there. And with a wrench, it'll just turn that loose. First, I'm going to undo these hydraulic lines. We have a catch pan. We'll drain the oil out. Now, I'm using a tubing wrench, just so you know. So it has a little slot, and then it's basically a box wrench. It's made for tubing fittings like this, so it slips over the tubing and you get into your nut. Now, I've already loosened these a little bit, so it makes it a little easier. But these wrenches, you won't screw up your nut. Now this has a lock nut on it, but I was able to grab that lock nut and now help me get this loose, but the whole thing came loose. So that's kind of, if I leave that alone, it basically seals up against it. This is a spring. So this is a spring that came out of here, and this is like a retainer plug. There we go, that popped off. O-rings throughout on that. So this is the retention part of it. On the other end of this, there's a like snap ring type retainer in here and a piece that will screw out. the seal retainer, I think it is, down in here. A lock ring right in here, and then this seal retaining type nut or bushing is here too. It needs to come out. That came out easy. All right, I just turned the pinion and this pushed this right on out. Nice and easy. Of course, it's gonna bleed all over. So we won't be able to slide it past this pinion, the rack, to get this out until we remove this and then remove the pinion. This is a smooth bore, doesn't have anything to grab onto. I see this to be a difficult part. So this is just a slipped in plug, and what I did is I reversed a pair of snap ring pliers, just reached in here and pinched it outward, and I was just able to pop that out. It just has an O-ring on it. There you go. All right, what I did here is I just put this, you know, strong pick here as a lever arm, and I just put it under here and pulled, and that pulled that out. Just pulled the pinion right out. There you go. Not too bad. Not too bad. Now, the seal kit for this, the steering unit, is, I don't know, it's about $30 or so. So it's not too bad, not too expensive, really, too. So it makes it a lot easier if you're going to pull it apart to do this mod. Because what we're going to do is this end here. Now, we've already cut the ends off, so they're the appropriate length, but I'm going, or close to it. I'm going to face these, this end, both ends, face them off in the lathe. This end is solid. This end will get drilled and tapped. The other end is a tube end, and here we're going to put an insert in that will be drilled and tapped, and then we'll weld that in. Now, this mod we're doing is you can buy one already modified for about $1,500. This is a proven mod in a sense. It's just that we're going to do it ourselves and make our own parts and such. So this is the setup, and this is a 6-jaw adjustable chuck. And what I've done is I put it up in here. Now it goes into the chuck here, probably 6 or 7 inches. It's in here quite a ways, and it will not fit in through my spindle, though. I dialed, checked this end, and adjusted it to within 0.5 thousandths with my 3 dials. Then I moved my indicator down here, right here, dialed the chuck in, 0.5 thousandths. Come back, check this, dial this in again, a little few small adjustments, and 0.5 thousandths. So we're really dialed in really nice. All we're going to do here is face this off and put a good chamfer on the inside and just break the edge on the outside. So when we press our piece in, it'll be flush with the end and we'll be able to TIG weld that in. So that would just be a weld relief. Then we'll flip it over. We'll clean up the other end and drill and tap it. I hope we'll tap it. I hope it's not too hard. I just put a little whey oil on there, and that usually suffices. Oh, not too hard. So the material is soft enough to cut with carbide. That's a good sign. Thank you. there just so we cleaned it up. There, there's a weld relief, that should be plenty. All right, that looks really good, and we're ready. I hit this edge with a file, and quick buff. We're ready to turn it around. Now we got turned around. Now we got quite a bit, about 9 inches sticking out on this end down here because of where the rack is, and I don't really feel like making a bushing that goes around there. But we're just gonna face this end off and tap it, so it should be okay. And we're gonna have to adjust this a little bit. All right, I'm 0.5 thousandths all the way along in 3 places, that's gonna be good enough. And like I said, we have about 9 inches sticking out here. We're just gonna face it, drill and tap it, so it shouldn't be too bad. I can't hold it here unless I make a bushing and run the bushing in the steady rest. So let's just see how it goes. Should be enough. So this is the piece that's going to go on here, and it's like a counterboard hole. It has a special screw or bolt that goes down in here, and this is metric, and I don't have a tap for this size metric, so we're just going to make this a imperial thread. And we'll just make a new bolt for this to hold that in. So we'll just measure this up and see what we're close to, and we'll go from there. Not too hard to center drill, so we should be able to drill this. All right, we're gonna go with 1/2 inch 20. Thread on these bolts and make new ones. I would prefer 9/16, 18 or a 14 millimeter, but since I don't have that, we're going to go with 1/2 inch 20. It's a little bit smaller, but we're going to make our own bolts for this out of 4130 pre-hardened material, which is extremely strong. So I don't have a problem with making a little bit smaller. All right, I drilled that 1.5 inches, so we get approximately 1 inch of thread. But we're gonna tap this 1/2-20. I'm gonna run a bottoming tap down in there to make sure we've got nice, clean, straight threads for 1 inch. All right, that phase is pretty much done for this, for the shaft here. So that's drilled and tapped, and then we'll, and this one's been cleaned up for the weld, so this is pretty much ready to go. We'll make the bushing that goes in here next, and that will have to be put in and then welded. And we need to make two bolts for the clevises that go on the end.